Boom! I'm Thundercloud, and I've come to tell you about my new book, Poetry to End Prohibition, the 420 edition. And I'm giving it away right now on Kindle. So if you want to click on the link underneath, you can get it and read it, the whole book, for free. Yeah. Now I'm going to read to you the main poem from the book, The Tawny Frogmouth. My inspiration for writing it. So here goes. The Tawny Frogmouth came to me very late one night. It was early in the morning, and it spoke very quiet. Us tawny frogmouths, the spirits of the dead who died from overdoses and systemic violence, he said. I've something important to say, and this is my position. Humans will not be free until you end prohibition. I'm a tawny frogmouth, and I see your frustration with the punitive justice drug war of incarceration, thousands of non-criminal users each year locked and jailed, but violent crime rates have fallen. The drug war's failed. 80% of the injustice system is wasted each year, locking up people for flowers and herbs. You're queer. It's obvious to me prohibition's failed. When you can harm minimise and empty most of the jails, make safe access to herbs and drugs a right, and save billions of taxpayers' dollars overnight. The police could focus on corruption and violent crime. Harm minimisation means there'd be less people dying. Harm minimisation means you support safe herb users, educate and rehabilitate the hard poison drug abusers. Less overdoses, violent crime gangs fade away when you grow herbs freely at home and juice cannabis each day. It's obvious to me that you must end prohibition. Call your politicians today. It's your mission. And explain all the benefits of ending the war on women, children, sick, elderly, coloured and poor. So I've come to visit you early in the morning, because you're the one who'll sound my warning. We wise tawny frogmouths think you humans are very strange. You seem so conservative and reluctant to embrace change. Mothers are in jail, nanas in there too, all because of the herbal cannabis and cookies that they grew. Prohibition's an attack on human rights. It's such an injustice. I have trouble sleeping at night. When prohibition exists, people live in fear of truth of being caught and imprisoned for a year. Please reconsider your perspective on prohibition of drugs. Free the plants and herbs and undercut the thugs. When you end prohibition, there'll be a reduction in crime. With harm minimisation, there'll be less parents crying. When you end prohibition, billions of dollars will be saved. Less cops, prisons, lawyers, death, more health and happiness every day. I haven't nearly finished because I'd love to go to sleep, but I find it very difficult because I often weep for the victims of the drug war, those overdosed and dead, brothers, sisters, children's death from cop kicks to their head. But now I want to talk about how women are being imprisoned throughout the world, increasingly putting sisters inside, victims of a system, and the men that deride the women that speak up and tell all the truth about the sex offenders and sex abuse. A misogynist system of women incarcerated while abusive men walk free, and women left frustrated, assaulted by judges, johns and police. Women made homeless to sleep on the streets with a back to the wall and one eye half open for fear of being raped, robbed or groping. She hasn't slept well. She's psychotic, insane, chemically restrained, injected, sectioned again. I want voluntary admission to the psych ward. God! She cries, injected, pushed back into the streets just to meet KPIs. Back in the street, she screams and rants in the back of a police car, a hand down her pants in the cell of a watch house. The cycle starts again, raped by judges, police. She questions if she's sane in a cycle that sees so many lives lost. The prison industrial complex has a high social cost. Do you get it? It's enough. The punitive justice system's unjust, abused in a system, have to prostitute themselves, intravenous diseases, STDs, mental health. I know you agree. Now is the time for my message to you. People are dying from incarceration, prohibition, being in prison while violent crime falls. Incarceration's risen and in 20 years has doubled in Australia, where the punitive justice system is a failure. The female prison population's doubled in less than 18 years. I'm feeling troubled. From 7 to 14% of the prison population, I provide these figures for your information. In 1950, only 4,000 people were in detention. Over 40,000 now. Here is my intention. It's time you reduced incarceration and restorative justice will end this frustration. Prisons must all be deprivatized, no more making laws to meet KPIs. Most of the prison population's non-violent, in for prohibition and fraud and money misspent non-violent crimes and illiteracy. 90% of the prison population should be free. In the last 5 years, an increase of 30% while violent crime is falling. Your system's bent. It criminalizes the socially vulnerable, sick, black, women and poor. There's a much better way for you to restore the broken and traumatized, locked up inside with caring, assistance, forgiveness applied to the injustice system that people don't trust, to make it compassionate and truly just, to simplify laws and eliminate state harm of forceful police twisting your arm. You can make a system that has love and heart first. Ending prohibition's a wonderful start. The money saved from excess police, jailed, put to help minimise abuse, because the drug wars failed to rehabilitate and help those imprisoned inside, so that when they're free, they're successful in their lives. The wise Tawny Frogmouth hooted. The words she spoke were true. I'm a Tawny Frogmouth. That's what you need to do. When you end prohibition, everything will be all right. Maybe then I'll get some sleep at night. And that's for Daniel Walmsley, who I tried to unsuccessfully resuscitate, who died from an OD when I arrived in Nimbin. Please, end prohibition, click the link and get the free book as well. And share it and send it to your politicians. And let's get some change. I'm Thundercloud. Boom!